Hello, comrades. In case you're wondering what I'm doing over winter in Russia while I'm away from Nürburgring, well, a bit of this. And this. And this. But mostly this. Today I'm at Vyshny Volochok, which is a village somewhere between Moscow and St. Petersburg. But it doesn't matter where we are, it matters what we're going to do today, which is learning about the laws of physics, and in particular that batteries die very fast in cold environment. So I better head inside and give you some voiceovers before my microphone dies again. Okay, let's get back. So we brought two cars with us to the frozen lake of Vyshny Volochok, the E36M3 and the NC Mazda MX-5. What we want to show you, comrades, is that you don't need huge budget or high power to have fun. All you need is to become friends with Alex from Car Throttle, because he owns both of the cars you see here. Let me tell you about the German Czech first, before talking about the Japanese one. If you keep watching long enough, I will tell you something about the Lada too. And something about the Prius. Repellent. Okay, let's get back to the M3. This is probably one of the least to be expected cars to go ice drifting, since it's a rear-wheel drive. However, it doesn't matter which type of drivetrain you're running when you put on these bad boys. Apart from that, the only other upgrade that stands out is the huge Erlen suspension, which was modified by Latvian Samsonas Racing. Cutting holes in your hood to fit big turbo? Too mainstream. In Soviet Russia, we cut holes to fit big suspension. For the rest, you could say the car is stock. It is running the original 286 horsepower first generation E36 M3 engine and drivetrain, which is more than enough to have fun. The benefit of driving on the ice is that you don't need to spend money on brake upgrades either. The only other obvious upgrades we can find inside, and most of them are everything you'd expect in a track-prepped car. Roll cage, bucket seats, aftermarket steering wheel, essential hydraulic handbrake. By the way, this is not a sequential gearbox, it's just an extended lever. One thing, however, is fucking genius. This piece of Latvian engineering allows you to close doors when you're strapped to the bucket seat by pulling here, which is the only place you can reach. Okay, enough talking, let's go driving. fun. Let's see how Mazda is doing. But before, let's take a break.
Красота, чё, не катай,
прикольно. Не, не, там ребята коротконоги у нас. Сейчас надо сидеть.
Так что тут топор есть.
Сейчас будет тоже, да?
Чтоб сиденье больше не двигали.
Быстро решение нашли. Вот
и сиденье надо двигать будет, да.
Коротконогие уже не справишь, блядь, а вот длинноногие, блядь, пиздели бы поменьше.
И язык тебе смысла нет отрезать, Оля ругаться будет, а вот, в принципе, ноги...
Now back to our hero of today, the third generation, fuck you, ICE, Mazda MX-5 NC. As for the mods, it has a custom-made roof to keep the driver's hair stylish in bad weather condition. It also has Russian ghetto snow-powered transmission cooling system to keep the car going. This may also be cocaine to keep the driver going. If the driver goes too fast and flips over, the roll cage is there to protect his haircut. Speaking of haircuts, ever wondered where all the hair from barbershop goes once it's cut off? Unlike the BMW, it has a suspension that does fit under the hood, which is a stock Bilstein B4. The reason it fits there is because it has two cylinders, 1 liter of displacement and 126 horsepower less than the BMW. Does this mean that it will be less fun to drive? Let's find out. To make a track on this frozen lake, we need to remove all the excessive snow. And for this, we have tractors. Wait, not those tractors. Those are for drifting. We have special tractors. Remember what I told you in the beginning, that you don't need big budget to have fun? Now the BMW may be the weapon of choice to attack the Nürburgring, and Mazda may be the queen of fashion. In Soviet Russia, Lada rules on every terrain. Just look at the mods, custom made side pipe for weight reduction. Even more weight reduction can be found inside the car. We don't need billet capitalist hydraulic handbrakes. All that weight had to go to compensate the vodka supply on board required to keep the driver going. And the doors can only be operated by a real man. Fuck you, Ice! 70 horsepower engine with 4 cylinder each making 2000 RPM require 11000 RPM gauge when the pilot decides to go pedal to the metal. And trust me, with my cousin Rescue Roman, it happens often. Fuck you, Ice! Now go, Roman, save some capitalist BMWs. Some comers were not that fortunate enough to get out of themselves, and so they had to stay here forever.